time to meet our first guests. They're a group of Year 12 students and they've produced Unitensil. It's an app that creates really tasty and affordable great food. Shall we meet them?
Thank you so much for joining us this evening, guys. Now, there are only seven of you here, but there are 15 Sutton Grammar students who were part of the app. Is that right?
That's right, yep.
Now, who had the original idea, or was it a result of brainstorming between you all?
Well, it was actually a result of brainstorming. So we had, at the very start of the competition, which started about September, we had about 4 weeks to think of something to create. And we knew from the start that we were going to make an app. We wanted to be quite original, innovative. So after about 4 weeks, we suddenly hit the jackpot when we thought, oh wait, there's quite a gap in the market with cooking apps and providing affordable meals, and we thought we could provide this, and that's what we did.
I think it's a fantastic app, but starting from scratch, you must have had quite a few hurdles to overcome to get where you are today. What was the biggest challenge, and was it easy to learn how to code?
Oh, well, yeah, that coding was the biggest challenge, and after reading one page of Coding for Dummies, we knew that we couldn't do this from scratch. So we started posting adverts around the school to ask if anyone in other years could code, and we found someone, and he is here today.
Okay, so you can tell when you look at the app that it's got some quite advanced features on it, such as the search thing. They were quite difficult to program, but it comes across really nicely when you do it, and I worked really hard to make it nice and smooth to fit exactly with the ideas that our designer, Krunal, gave us as well. Yeah, and it ended up being very good, I think, yeah.
After spending such a long time developing the app, how did you feel when you actually released it?
It was quite a fun thing to do because we launched it on the quiz night that we had. So that was a fundraiser, and we also used it as like a launch party almost. So we launched it and had a bit of Prosecco for the adults there. It was good fun.
Who would you say is your target audience for this app? Students or any teenager or young person based in the UK or worldwide?
We started off thinking, oh, we'll do this for university students. It's the people who need it most. But then as we got more into it, we realised this could be for anyone. This could be for adults. It can be for children who want to get into cooking. So we realised it's an app for all ages all around the country.
So what's the reaction been to the app so far? Have you had to make any improvements already?
Well, we've already had one update, so the very first release had a few bugs, and as all apps do, so we refined that and ironed that and made it so much better. And already our second update has many positive reviews. We have quite a few on the Play Store where it's being sold. We've got many comments on our social networks like Twitter, Facebook, people telling us how good the app is, and hopefully more people get to explore and find this.
And finally, what would you say your advice would be to anyone who has a good idea for an app but doesn't know where to start?
Go for it. Just find someone who can maybe program for you, or maybe take some time to learn how to code. I'm sure it's quite a hard thing to do, but it might be worth the effort when you finish it, and you'll enjoy it that you've created something by yourself.
The end of our latest show of SVTV. We hope you've enjoyed it, and don't forget to keep up to date with all the latest news, opinion and events from around Sutton at suttonvoice.co.uk.
You can also follow Sutton Voice on Twitter and Facebook. Thank you very much for joining us.